Palestinians. I think that's going to be happening at some point because it makes a lot of sense for them to let it happen.
Do you support annexation of Palestinian land by Israelis at this point?
Well, we're talking to Israel about that right now, actually.
What about the snapback option on Iran? Do you support that?
Oh, you really know your stuff, don't you? Well, we're not going to talk to you about that. We're going to work something out, and then we'll talk after it's completed. But it'll be very satisfactory.
Why now did they come to an agreement?
We've been working on this for a long time. It's been a labor of love for a lot of the people in this room. And a lot of them love Israel, and a lot of them love the Middle East, and they love the countries that we're talking about, like UAE, as an example, standing right here. And it's been a labor of love. They know it has to happen. And I don't want to be speaking too much about it, but if you look what's happened since I broke up that ridiculous Iran nuclear deal, money isn't going to some horrible, horrible groups, and you haven't seen the kind of terrorism that you saw before. Now, I don't like saying it, because all of a sudden they'll say, we've got to do something. But you know what? They're not getting money because Iran isn't giving money. And I appreciate that. But Iran is going through very difficult times, and I appreciate that. And I'll say this, and I can say it very publicly, that if I win the election, I will have a deal made with Iran within 30 days. They'll make a very fast deal. They're dying to make a deal, but they'd much rather negotiate with sleepy Joe Biden than with us.
Why did Joe do that?
But we'll be having a deal made very, very quickly. But, you know, rightfully, they're waiting till after the election because they would. There's nothing China, Iran, Russia, all of them would like to see more than have Trump be defeated where they could deal with Joe Biden, because that would be like a dream. And this was something that was very exciting. We thought this would be the first country. He's a great leader. Mohammed's a great leader. And we're very happy that he was the first country, I would say. And you're going to see many other things happening in the Middle East over a fairly short period of time. But this is the first time in more than 25 years. And UAE is big stuff. UAE is very powerful, very strong, has one of the strongest militaries. It's big stuff.
Do you know when the delegations are going to meet specifically?
Very soon. I guess they'll be setting up the meetings. Do you have any time?
I think the next several weeks, Mr. President. And then we expect that there will be a meeting here at the White House with the leaders.
There'll be an official signing at the White House over the next few weeks. Okay. And other than that, we'll meet you at 5:30 or so. We'll talk and we'll actually take one of your questions. Okay.
Ms. President.
All right, guys.